copyright reasons. God damn it. I don't know why, but they require you to show the screen, the intro screen with the music. And it would say copyright Nintendo made in Japan or something like that. It would say something like that. It needs to be clearly seen on the video. And the thing is that the intro music lasts like 16 seconds. So in reality, you spend more time looking at the intro screen and hearing the intro music than actually running the first level. Because Mario just goes straight to the ladder, and if you're lucky enough, you clip on the stair, pop out on the top of the window of the screen, excuse me, and finish the level in like 11 seconds. But Mario takes like 6 to 7 seconds to walk to the stairs. So, as I said earlier, basically, literally on the first 7 to 8 seconds you are resetting the run because you are not getting the clip. My PB gets the clip actually. I got the clip. It took forever. Absolutely insanely forever. And apart from that, that's just the first level. Which is already a pain. The first level. You still need to rely on the RNG for the fireball on the next level. There is a fireball in the next level that is just chaotically walking around. And it's pretty funny because after hundreds of attempts of getting the step clip, literally the next thing is hoping the fireball won't screw you up. Because the fireball moves chaotically all around. Yeah, there is a lot of patience. I quit that game already. I'd like to speedrun it again, but it will take hundreds of attempts, literally hundreds of attempts. If I don't get a good run of this game, since I started too early, I'm not promising anything, but I may try Donkey Kong tonight. The classic Donkey Kong for NES, and see if I can PB that one. It's very basic, it's not a complicated game to speedrun. And a full run of that game is no more than 1 minute and 20 seconds. It's super fast. It's a very, very short game, it's just 3 levels. Three levels, and the first level lasts at most like 15 seconds. The next level, second level, lasts maybe 23 seconds. And the final level is the longest, and it's like 40 seconds if you have like really bad luck. My PB is 1 minute and 9 seconds. That's my PB. Let me see if I can find the video. Oh, I don't think I have enough time on the cutscene to find the run. Well, you can look for it on my speedrun profile. That's one thing. But I would like to see the run. But no, I don't have enough time to. It is on YouTube, yes. Like, if you click on my speedrun profile and search the game and the run, it will be linked to a YouTube video. There's the video on YouTube. But it's from before I had the webcam. When I started speedrunning, I didn't use webcam. And my Donkey Kong attempts have no webcam. It's just my voice. But it's there. Oh shit. Get high, Mario. Ooh, gold. Rainbow split. Yeah, that's unfortunate. I wanted to kick the P-switch up, but I'm gonna lose it, so... Just go easy. Let's just go easy. My favorite game to speedrun. Well, that is a hard question. It's a really hard question. I think the most rewarding is Super Mario Bros. 1 for the NES, because that is classic among classics. But honestly, it's a horror to speedrun that game. Every time I get into Super Mario Bros. 1 for the NES, I don't enjoy the game at all. It's really rewarding, I'm not gonna lie. It's really rewarding to PB that game. And it is an amazing game, I love the game so much. But speedrunning it is absolute pain and horror. I don't like that. I don't enjoy that one. But it's super rewarding, so the fact that it's super rewarding may be a good reason to see to make it a really fun game to speedrun. One of my favorites. Even though I don't... I know it sounds like I'm contradicting myself. But that's part of the magic. It's a complicated game that is super absolute horrendous to run, but it's at the end it's super rewarding. That it makes it... It just makes it better. And then, Super Mario World, when it comes to Super Mario World, I'm better in Super Mario World. This is the best game for me to run. I'm really good at this game. Or at least I think I'm good. I don't know, you guys be the judges. But I think I'm good in the game. God fucking damn it! Just... Oh, of course you get in the... Dude! Just get in the freaking... Oh, I hate this game. What was I saying? Oh yeah, I think I'm good in the game. But I can be better. Yo, Ness. Thank you for the good luck. I'm gonna save time anyway. And I save time just because I got an easy vertical room. Not an easy, a good vertical room. The vertical room was really good. But the first room was not. How's it going, Ness? Bienvenido al stream. I'm sorry you have to heard how I complain about the game. That's the magic of speedrunning. Okay, no wings for... ¿Ya volviste? ¿Cómo te va? ¿Cómo está todo, por cierto? Es lo que más es importante. Que la gente realmente se cuide. Oh, virtuales, yo pensé que físicas. Aquí en Chihuahua sí les quieren hacer presenciales ya. Oh my gosh, I missed this one. Tengo sentimientos encontrados hacia eso. Me gustaría que las cosas volvieran a la normalidad, pero sé que a la gente no le gusta seguir las reglas. Es que creo que no habría problema en regreso presencial si la gente supiera tomar medidas preventivas, o no confiarse, o no pensar que por el hecho de que podamos salir, todo va a estar bien. Voy a usar la estrella. Hay una estrella aquí arriba y la quiero. ¿Tú si apoyas el regreso presencial o...? ¿O qué opinas? Yo lo apoyaría si supiera o tuviera la confianza de que las personas realmente van a cuidar las cosas, la situación. Van a traer todo su cubrebocas, van a respetar distancia. Pero pienso que no lo van a respetar. Entonces sí me gustaría mucho que volviera toda la normalidad. O sea, la normalidad en el sentido de reactivar las cosas. Que las cosas vuelvan a estar activas. Obviamente cuidándonos todos, pero reactivar las cosas. Pero es que no lo van a hacer, ese es el problema. La gente no va a hacer caso. Todo se podría reactivar muy bien si la gente se tomara en serio las medidas preventivas. Si no se lo tomaran como un libertinaje, sino que sepan que es importante reactivar las cosas, pero que no tienen que aprovechar eso para ir de antro, cosas así. ¿Ya tienes tu vacuna? Yo tengo la mía. Tengo la de Pfizer, pero tengo la primera dosis nada más. Aún estoy esperando la siguiente. Me puse la primera dosis de Pfizer. Tengo que esperar a que me hablen para la segunda. Conozco algunos que nada más que se pusieron la de una dosis nada más. La de Pfizer a mí me dio fiebre. Pero nada más. Duré 2 días con un poquito de fiebre, pero después de eso todo excelente. ¿Sabes cuál? Bueno, si es Pfizer, probablemente te vaya a dar fiebre, pero no pasa nada, ¿eh? O sea, no te tumba ni te hace daños. Simplemente es como que es más pesada. Como que la dosis de la Pfizer es muy fuerte. Y tienes que... como que la tienes que tomar con calma. Prepararte porque algo así va a pasar. Aunque otras personas que he escuchado que usaron la Pfizer no les pasó absolutamente nada. Casi todos mis amigos no les pasó nada. Nada más fui yo al que le dio fiebre. Pero si te da, no te vayas a preocupar. No pasa nada. Aunque todavía estoy esperando mi segunda dosis. Quiero mi segunda dosis. Thank you. Cold? Nice. Tal vez no lo crean, pero esa parte me pone muy nervioso. The first part of this castle makes me very, very anxious. Yeah, 14 segundos. No entiendo cómo hice PB la última vez. No sé qué hice bien en mi PB porque claramente tengo mucha ventaja. Así que algo hice bueno al final de la ronda entonces. Creo que el final de la ronda debe ser muy bueno, como para que tenga esta ventaja tan temprano. Uf. Nice. Yes. This is PB for World 3. I'm pretty sure this has to be PB. 1605. What is my PB? World 3. 1647. Yes, this is PB. Okay, we got a PB today. We got a PB. Okay, I gotta save this video now because this is PB for World 3. At least I got a PB today. I have something to upload. A good stream is when I have something to upload to YouTube, and this is PB for World 3.